Dear students of second year civil engineering SIM, I am T.K. Sen, head of the department of civil engineering of your institution. Today I will throw some light on high performance concrete. High performance concrete is not a revolutionary material, nor does it contain ingredients which are not used in the concrete considered so far. Rather, high performance concrete is a development over the years. The very name high performance concrete smacks of advertising an allegedly distinct product. A former name was high strength concrete, but in many cases it is a high durability that is the required property, although in others it is high strength, either very early or at 28 days or even later. In some applications, a high modulus of elasticity is the property sought for. With respect to strength, it can be noted that the meaning of the term high strength has changed significantly over the years. Say for example, at one time 40 MPa was considered as high. Later on 60 MPa became viewed as high strength concrete. Now high performance in terms of strength can be taken as a compressive strength in excess of 80 MPa. In passing, it can be said at these high strengths, the difference between test results on cubes and on cylinders is minimal, so that except for compliance purposes, the distinction between the two types of test specimens is of little importance. In some publications, a subdivision of high performance concrete into classes according to strength is introduced, and terms such as very high performance concrete are used. This does not seem to be a rational approach to a material with a continuous gradation in properties and with no discontinuities in ingredients. High performance concrete contains some ingredients such as common, albeit good quality aggregate, ordinary type 1 Portland cement at a very high content, say for example 450 to 550 kg per meter cube, silica fume, generally 5 to 15% by mass of the total cementitious material, sometimes other cementitious materials such as fly ash or ground granulated blast furnace slag, and always and must a super plasticizer. The dosage of the super plasticizer is high, 5 to 15 liters per cubic meter of concrete, depending on the solids contents in the superplasticizer as well as on its nature. Such a dosage allows a reduction in water content of about 45 to 75 kg per meter cube of concrete. Other admixtures can also be present, but polymers, epoxies, fibers and processed aggregates such as calcined bauxite, sand can be excluded. It is essential that high performance concrete is capable of being placed in the structure by conventional methods and that is cured in the usual manner. Although particularly good moist curing is required to achieve high strength. What makes the concrete a high performance one is a very low water cement ratio, always below 0.35, often around 0.25 and occasionally even 0.20. The properties of concrete containing silica fume and a super plasticizer applies to high performance concrete, but because of the very low water cement ratio in the latter, these properties are accentuated. Indeed, high performance concrete can be said to be a logical development of concrete containing silica fume and a super plasticizer. To give an example, it is possible to produce a mix with a slump of 180 to 200 mm at a water cement ratio between 0.2 to 0.3. Thus, the water content is 130 to 140 kg per meter cube of concrete as compared with 170 to 200 kg per meter cube in a non-air entrained mix of ordinary concrete with a slump of 100 to 120 mm. The high performance concrete means concrete with a high strength or a low permeability. The two properties, although not necessarily concomitant, are linked to one another because high strength requires a low volume of pores, especially of the larger capillary pores. The only way to have a low volume of pores is for the mix to contain particles graded down to the finest size, that is achieved by the use of silica fume or microsilica, which fills the spaces between the cement particles and between the aggregate and the cement particles. However, the mix must be sufficiently workable for the solids to be dispersed in such a manner that this dense packing is achieved, which requires deflocculation of cement particles. This is achieved by the use of a superplasticizer at a large doses. The superplasticizer must be effective with the given Portland cement, that is, the two materials must be compatible. When the above conditions have been satisfied, high performance concrete is achieved. The concrete is very dense, it has a minimal volume of capillary pores, and these pores become segmented upon curing. At the same time, the significant proportion of Portland cement remains unhydrated, even when the concrete is in the contact with the water, because water cannot penetrate through the pore system so as to reach the unhydrated remnants of Portland cement. These remnants can be viewed as very fine aggregate particles, which are extremely well bonded to the products of hydration. Thank you.